Welcome back to Johnny United Stadium on the campus of Towson University in Baltimore, Maryland for USA Football's 2015 development games. As we will pit in our final game of the day, the silver team led by Coach Adam Neugebauer versus the blue team led by Coach Tony Testa. Hello, football fans. I'm Jeremy Huber, joined again by Emery Hunt. And Emery, we've seen two good games already. I got a feeling this could be the best of the best.
You look for an explosive play late in game between the offense, defense side of ball on both teams. They practice hard all week, and I'm excited to see these guys get out here and play.
Most definitely should be another good one, as we've seen two really hard-fought contests so far on the day. Let's go ahead and take a look at our players to watch in this one for both the silver team and the blue team.
You look at the offensive lineman, Joseph Garza, big-time offensive tackle. Does a great job on both ends of offense.
And, of course, another guy to watch out for, John Curvin, the standout tight end. Of course, some other guys as well. Looking at the coaching staffs for the silver team, Adam Neugebauer out of Tiffin University, the head coach.
And Chad Byers out of Furman University, great program down there. The Paladins do a great job defensively, and he's probably a big reason why.
And of course, look at that, an entire college staff. Same for the blue team under head coach Tony Testa out of West Virginia Wesleyan College.
Lee Rose did a great job. I saw all week, you know, working his defensive line, working those guys up front out of Butler University.
So, going to go ahead. Of course, you look at the coaches for this. Of course, USA Football putting this event on. And of course, a little bit more information about USA Football. Take a look at that right now.
We believe in football. We believe in Friday Night Lights, Saturday afternoons, any given Sunday. And we believe in where all of that began. We believe heroes are made in the fourth quarter, and that every kickoff is a fresh start. We believe in pregame rituals and halftime speeches. We believe the best 11 will always beat the 11 best. We believe in teaching fundamentals, building character. We believe in educated coaches and engaged parents. We believe in creating a positive experience for all and in keeping the game fun. We believe in team. We believe in the lineage of Bryant, Rockne, Lombardi, and Dad. We believe you don't need a stadium or yard lines to have a game. We believe that even greater than the heroes on the big screen are those you give a ride to home from the game. We believe there is nothing more American than football, and that football gives us all something to believe in. Teamwork. Confidence. Pride. We are USA Football. We believe the scoreboard doesn't tell the whole story. We believe in the football family and that we can achieve a better, safer game together. We believe in football.
Thank you.
Our national anthem, such a big part of things here at USA Football at our development games. Of course, you saw the flag bearers. Such a big honor here at these games. Ryan Casey for the silver team. Amadou Dunbar for the blue team. Today's game brought to you by Sports Authority, the official sporting goods provider of USA Football. Today's game also brought to you by Riddell, the official helmet and protective equipment partner of USA Football. Seeing our captains taking the field for the coin toss for Team Silver, number 22, Michael Magapinto, number 24, Keith Jackson, number 35, Nathaniel Bowditch, and number 88, John Curvin. For the blue team, number 7, Deontay Jones, number 10, Chauncey Caldwell, number 52, Ryan Peterson, and number 77, Pierce Banbury. And, of course, these two teams, really some standouts we're going to see in this game, Emery. You see, we talked about in the last game, it's this one as well. Seen a lot of guys going into that senior year, that junior year, really should be a high-level football in this contest.
And this is what you want to see from these guys. How well can they start their senior or junior season? And you should see a high level of play from juniors and seniors, as you would expect. And you want to see how can these guys consistently get better over the course of their time in high school.
And, you know, it has to be an honor for these guys and really, really fun to go ahead. As we mentioned, both coaching staffs for these two teams entirely made up of college coaches. And obviously, you know, there's some coaches in high school who choose to coach high school ball, and they're great at it and they love it. I've had talked to guys before like this who said, you know, hey, I love it because I kind of get these guys ready to go to the next level, and that's what they really like. But it has to be a thrill for some of these guys still in high school to kind of play under all college coaching staff, and we'll see exactly how things pan out today as the silver team's going to win the toss, and we are almost ready for football here at Towson for our third game of the day, and really should be an exciting one.
Absolutely, and how often do you get to be able to be coached by college guys? If you're a high school player, and you would embrace that coaching because that's helping get you to where you ultimately want to be, which is the next level.
And these players, obviously, and we'll talk about it, their pathway kind of through when it comes to the U.S. national program, but going through the regional camps, then, of course, the development games here, then with the ultimate eyes on the prize of getting to the International Bowl later on in the year. And we're ready to go here. As the silver team is going to play on offense first, the blue team will be on defense. Remember, if you'd like to interact with us on social media, you can do it on Twitter and on Instagram, both at USNFT. That's USNFT, as you see on your screen. So Team Silver ready to go, and they're going to go deep early on. Some miscommunication as coming out early. Connor Fitzsimmons looking for the long bomb, and his receiver going a little bit short.
Connor Fitzsimmons out of Brooklyn, New York, up in my area. Here's a guy, again, wanting the big play early. You like that aggressiveness. You like them going deep down the field, but they have to get on the same page with their wide receiver, like you mentioned.
Fitzsimmons out of Fort Hamilton High School. Will be flanked by his running back, Michael Magapinto, who's going to take the carry here. Magapinto on his feet, going to get a gain of 11 on the play. And he's another one, just like we saw in our previous game with Doug Santos, diminutive running back that's put up some big-time stats and really runs great.
Magapinto starting the game with bursts. But again, you want to see how can he consistently keep this up over the course of the game. Is this first carry jitters right there, or first carry energy? Or will he have the same type of burst and explosiveness in the second and third quarters?
Broke off a tackle by a much bigger player there. Now, quick pass. That one going to be incomplete as Fitzsimmons tried to get that one out quick and just never seemingly got the laces and kind of threw it end over end.
A little bit of a timing issue so far in the passing game we've seen from all of the three games. But this one in particular, receivers not running the full routes, maybe the quarterback not on the same page. But, again, we've normally seen this within the first couple of minutes of the first quarter, and it'll get ironed out as we move forward.
Yeah, definitely saw that in our second game where, as play advanced, got into the second quarter, both teams got into a groove and had a really well-played football game after that. Magapinto drags a tackler or two, gets 3 yards on the play. That'll set up a 3rd and 7.
Guys that are built low to the ground are very tough to get a wrangle on. You see Magapinto right here on a replay. Kick out blocked by the offensive lineman, cutting back inside and making it a tough tackle for the defender.
Carter McClellan of Huntersville, North Carolina, making the tackle on that play. Magapinto with some pretty impressive stats, as we'll go ahead and get into over the game, as I'm sure we're going to see him carry the ball a good bit today. Fitzsimmons throws it out, crossing pattern, going to have first down yardage. Nice play by the Silver team as he hooks up with Jalen Riley for the first down.
Nice catch by Jalen Riley, soft catch, being able to turn the sideline and get upfield. But again, this is something we haven't seen in the first two games, a team working the short to intermediate passing game. This is a short, safe play, but it ends up being a big play for this team because it's the first down.
So Fitzsimmons, again, leading him out, and we've seen this from most of the teams today. Four wide receiver sets with either a pistol or a shotgun formation, jumping off sides, and that's going to be encroachment on the defense as they throw it deep and actually hook up on the play. The defensive back kind of slowed down once he heard the whistle. That's going to be a 5-yard gain for the Silver team.
And what we've seen early is, again, play's going to even out, and this game will get a lot cleaner as we move forward. First quarter jitters.
Looking at the USA football alumni, such a great list. You look at Todd Gurley, Jameis Winston, a few other guys in the NFL and doing some very good things. Of course, brought to you by Upper Deck, the official trading card partner of USA football and the U.S. national teams. Quick screen, that's going to be incomplete. Looking to hook up with Travail Calvin, and unfortunately not able to do so. That's going to bring up a 3rd and 5.
Big play right here for the offense team, Silver. You want to see if maybe they can run it on 3rd down. They've had success running the football. Magapinto has done a great job so far getting downhill quickly. He has a little bit of burst. So you want to say maybe they have the option to run here and pick up this first.
Need to get it to the 35-yard line for a 1st down. Try to keep and end up giving it to Magapinto, as it looked like that Fitzsimmons wanted to pull it, couldn't get it out. Magapinto stuffed at the line of scrimmage to bring up a 4th down.
Yeah, that's always tough between a quarterback and a running back in that situation. The running back wants the football. The quarterback has to decide, okay, am I going to give it to you or am I going to keep it? And he made the right choice of trying to keep the football to get outside, but tough play right there between a QB and a running back.
Head coach and offensive coordinator Adam Neugebauer going to go ahead and go for it here on 4th and a long 5. Fitzsimmons looking deep. He's got a man. Incomplete, though. Couldn't hook up with Jalen Riley. Had a step down the middle. Couldn't complete the pass. And that's going to bring up a change of possession. Excuse me. That was a 3rd down. Excuse me, folks. So that's actually it was a 3rd down play and not a 4th down. So that'll bring up a punting situation.
Right decision, right choice, but you want to see a little bit more accurate of a pass. But again, you had the two seams working, the tight end and the receiver. Good throw, just a bit outside for the receiver to make the catch.
Looks like John Kervin may have had a step on his man, and then a punt there. That's going to go out of bounds, a little bit shorter than would have liked, as Kyle Corbett, maybe some opening game jitters for him, as that one a little bit short. So give pretty good field position to the blue team as they'll start out just inside their own 30-yard line. Kyle DeOrio will lead out the blue team. DeOrio from North Bergen, New Jersey, North Bergen High School. He'll be headed into his junior year.
It's a pretty strong program right there in North Bergen. That's right in my backyard. Good football being played in Bergen County, and definitely in North Bergen has a strong history of good high school football.
DeOrio gets the snap. He'll hand off, and again, the Silver defense coming up big there, stopping in the hole as Amadou Dunbar takes a loss on the play. Let's send it down to the sidelines and our Jack Feely.
Guys, thanks very much. One of the last players we're going to be profiling in this last match happening behind me is actually on the field right now, number 7, Shane Chavis out of Baltimore's Kenwood High School. He's about 5'6", 150 pounds, and he's looking to try and use this development camp as a way to try and open the eyes of college recruiters. Now, I say 5'6", 150 pounds. That's not big at all. In fact, he's one of the smallest kids on the field that we've seen on the field all day. But the reason why we decided to profile him was just because of his outgoing personality, but also his dedication to the sport and his confidence. In fact, I'm going to read you a quote here that we read in one of the players' questionnaires that he filled out. He said, quote, "If it's God's will, I see myself making a difference for the greater good, impacting the rising youth of the next generations to come, while using my influential outlets and capital that I've acquired along the way from a prosperous and fulfilling career in the NFL. This kid, remember, is only 17. Now, I can't remember if I was 17, if I ever said something as prophetic as that, but he absolutely loves football. He consistently surrounds himself with the intensity of Ray Lewis. He absolutely loves Ray Lewis and listens to his speeches all the time on his headphones, and he's going to see if he can try and make a name for himself here at this camp. I asked him which colleges are taking a look at. He said two so far. Morgan State has expressed an interest, and Towson. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Jack. Silver team making a nice stop on defense. Big hit there. Ashanti Brown getting in and making a nice play to break that play up. And then a nice punt on the other end after having some trouble on the first one. Kyle Corbett with a nice kick there to really flip the field a little bit.
A quick three and out by Team Blue. Team Silver gets a second chance. You see the offense going to come out, see what they can do, and perhaps try to move this football downfield with a little bit more cohesiveness in the passing game.
So the Team Silver will scrimmage from their own 31-yard line. Of course, they're wearing the all-silver jerseys, the all-blue jerseys today for Team Blue. Pretty simple and easy.
And a lot easier on the eyes for us up here in the booth to be able to see the blue jerseys. All the jerseys have been great, but this blue just pops.
It does. It does. I got to give them credit on that one. New quarterback in for Team Silver. Pass out in the flat for John Curvin. He's going to tiptoe the sidelines, then takes a hit and banged out of bounds at the 41, 42-yard line. So that'll be first down yardage. Of course, into the game, Derek Suazo from Garfield, New Jersey, at that play there. So a nice pass over to Curvin, who's a big target. And again, you see right here, we talked about Woodbury Forest, their bevy of tight ends. He's the best one as Curvin goes and attends the Woodbury Forest down in Virginia.
That's a great throw right there and a great catch. Being able to turn your back to the defense and reset and being able to fire an accurate pass is a great job of the QB. Another guy in my backyard.
Deontay Jones with the tackle there. That one's going to be incomplete, and a flag goes down. Looks like there may be some pass interference called as he couldn't help with Keith Freeman, but it looks like Jamel Wiggins may have had too close coverage on the play.
Yeah, he seems like he carried a defender on that one. Guy was on his back the whole play. Good job, though. Almost made the catch. Again, you have to be able to make contested catches as you move forward within levels. And if he's able to do that, that bodes well for his future.
So, they're going to move the chains. The chain gang wasn't exactly sure what they were supposed to do for a second, but it is pass interference, so it's an automatic first down. And Derek Suazo, your quarterback out of Queen of Peace High School in New Jersey. Quick pass out in the flat. Going to be a minimal gain as Jalen Riley gets what he can get and gets down.
Yeah, those passes, you really want your guys in space to make that one guy miss, the first guy miss. It just so happened he had two guys on that one, so it was tough. He got the most out of it, gained 3 yards.
Interesting story with Jalen Riley, according to our research, that underwent open heart surgery, I believe, when he was younger. So, obviously, a tough guy to go through that at any age. Of course, out of Independence High School in the Charlotte area. 4 wide, 2nd and 8 for Team Silver. Handoff up the middle. Again, going to be a 2-yard gain there. That time, Kobe Smith with the carry, and a flag goes down. And now, some issues back behind the ball. And haven't seen a lot of that today, and hopefully don't see much of it. And we'll see some of the alumni again, brought to you by Upper Deck, the official trading card partner of U.S. football and the U.S. national team. And these are your guys who are currently in schools right now, as opposed to the pros we showed you earlier. Samaje Perine of Oklahoma, also Kevin Hogan of Stanford, the quarterback, and Anu Solomon, the quarterback of Arizona. Really a very good lineup of guys who've played through the USA football program.
And you look at Kevin Hogan, a QB out of Stanford, expecting to have a big year out there on the Pac-12.
Let me see minimal gain up front. A couple guys behind the play getting a little over-anxious. And interestingly, I think we definitely saw the coaching staff of the blue team kind of nip that in the bud pretty quickly, which you don't want to see out there. You gotta keep control when you're playing. That's always a big thing when you're playing football.
It's hot, summertime, I get it, but again, this is a game that teaches development and fundamentals, and this is, you know, exactly what you want to see out there from those guys that are on the field now playing.
So a first and 10 here. Need to take it to the 19 for a first down. Suazo pump fakes, keeps the play alive, throws it deep. That one's incomplete. Good idea by Suazo, but just couldn't connect with Tavon Chapman Green.
And good blitz pickup right there by the back. I want to say that was Kobe Smith from Pittsburgh, Massachusetts. Right here, you see coming off the edge, he does a great job picking up the blitz, but a great job by the QB making sure he doesn't force a bad throw, actually making a good throw, which is throwing it away.
And you got to like the fact that Suazo, unlike a lot of high school quarterbacks, was scrambling to pass there.
Exactly, and that's the thing you want to see. If you're a college coach, you say, okay, this is the guy that gets it, and that's the type of a guy you want to work with.
You see so many times, even at the high school or the college and pro levels, where you'll see guys, once they run, they're thinking run, 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 not, hey, maybe this will make a big play for me. Throw this one out in the flat. It's going to be complete. Ball's loose. He ends up out of bounds, I believe. They're going to say it stays with the silver team. And they will. That pass was caught by Gavin Welch and end up fumbling it, but went out of bounds, so it stays with Team Silver.
And that's a lucky play right there. You want that type of luck on your side offensively, but a good job getting upfield, making the guy miss, but you want to protect that football. Six pressure points of the football, keep it on your outside arm, so that way it goes out of bounds.
The other thing, which was done well by Wells, is he did put the ball in the outside arm, correct?
Mm-hmm, exactly, and that's what you want, because again, if it was in the inside arm, falls into the field of play, and now we're talking about a turnover.
So a third and four here instead of that turnover for Suazo. Flips it out into the flat. Going to be very close to the sticks. I believe about a yard short as he hits Smith, trying to just take the check down, and he will be 1 yard short. And I'd have to think that Coach Neugebauer at this point, no decision at all. He's going to go ahead and go for it here, as we see Smith on the replay made one man miss but couldn't make the last two.
And that's the thing, but he got it short enough to where it's a manageable fourth down. And I like the aggressiveness early on to make this guy, to make this team go for it. And again, this is the type of situations you want to put your team in and see how mentally tough they are.
Suazo maybe changing the play, comes up and tries to go for a sneak, and he may have caused his center to commit a false start, and he did. That's a tough one. I know what he was doing there. It's just sometimes it's a tough play because you're trying to jump up there, but I think he almost pushed him forward and caused the center to move.
A little bit over anxious right there, but we're going to see a punt now from the silver team, or field goal, I'm sorry.
And good coaching there by Coach Neugebauer, coming over and talking to his quarterback. I think just kind of coached him up, say, hey, got to be a little bit less anxious on that one. So Kyle Corbett to attempt the field goal. This will be spotted just outside the 31. So a 41-yard field goal try for Corbett. No rush. Corbett's kick. It's long enough, and it's good. So really our first long field goal of the day we've seen, as Corbett puts one through and gives the silver team an early 3-0 lead.
And leads are important early in the game, because now you start to formulate the second part of your game plan because of it. So you got a 3-0 lead. Now your defense comes out. The blue team is their second possession offensively, and how aggressive will they be? They had a fumble snap right here on the field goal, but he was able to get it down, make the long kick.
Plenty of leg on that one. Probably been good from 45, maybe 47. So now the blue team again in a four wide receiver set, and again a low snap, and this one is just going to be picked up and an easy sack off the edge. In at the quarterback spot now, it's Price Still out of Friendswood, Texas.
Yeah, there's nothing much he can do on that play. You know, you have to pick the ball up and get rid of it or you eat it, and just so happened a defensive end made it to him at the same time he was able to get possession of the ball.
So Still now facing second and long, throws one out in the flat. It'll be complete, but about a four-yard gain as Stanley Jenkins brought it in.
That's a good catch by Jenkins because, again, you see right here on the replay, nice technically sound play up at the top of the screen, runs his hitch, extends out, and catches the football. That's perfect. That's textbook. It keeps you in between the defender and the ball, and that way the defender can't knock the ball away, which is why he was able to catch that football. And now we have third and long, but a little bit more manageable.
Still, hands off up the middle. Going to be well short of the first down as Eric Jung out of Bainbridge Island, Washington, got his first carry of the game. It's about three or four, but still comes up 9 yards short of the first down and should bring up a punting situation, and Corbett already out on the field for the blue team. So kind of both teams parrying each other, trying to kind of just see what each other is all about right now. Nice punt here by Corbett.
Beautiful punt.
Again, some of the guys we saw it a little bit in the first game having trouble making sure they're back deep enough with the different rules there. You know, where you might let go of your head in a real game, you want to make sure you're catching here.
Right.
And or a game with special teams full live go, I guess we should say. But that's going to put the ball back at the 21-yard line. So the Team Silver will start from there as they look to extend out their three-point lead.
It's going to be big. We saw a little movement from this offense, getting the running game going, making plays in the passing game, and now you want to see how well can they, again, build on what they've done the first two drives. Can they put it all together and punch it in the end zone? We saw it stall because of a penalty. Maybe they can get that thing going now with a new quarterback in the fold and perhaps put seven on the board.
Fitzsimmons in again after starting the game. This one's going to be batted down, and a big play from one of the big defensive linemen up front and getting the big paw up there, number 67, Sean Roberts Jr.
Yeah, that was a big play right there. Hands in the face, hands up at the line of scrimmage. And a lot of times batted passes are due to the fact that the quarterback stares down his target. So you want to see, you know, Fitzsimmons do a better job of maybe using his eyes to buy him some time and also keep that defensive lineman guessing.
Roberts out of Crossland High School. Good program in the Maryland area. Handoff up the middle. This is going to get a gain of about four on the play. Ramsey on the carry there.
You like that play right there. Again, the offensive line does a great job kicking out that in man on the line of scrimmage, and the back is cutting it right up where he's cutting the block and doing a great job getting upfield north and south without any wasted movements.
That'll bring up a third. We'll call it five. Need to get it out to the 31-yard line for a first down. Team Silver up 3-0 here, under 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. Fitzsimmons. Going to flip it out to Ramsey. Ramsey, the blue team, sniffs that one out perfectly and brings him down for a loss of three.
I tell you this about Coach Testa's squad, Team Blue, and what they've done defensively. They've been very aggressive, and they're a physical bunch. They're nasty, and you can see it in the way they attack the football once it's in space. They've done a great job playing the ball in space up front. They got to get it together a little bit, but their defense has done a fine job. Now we can see, now that they're getting the ball back offensively, how will that translate? Because they've gotten three good stops right now.
A lot of work today for Kyle Corbett. And again, another good punt by Corbett. His first one wasn't very good. Everyone's sense has been great. That's going to send the return man all the way back to the 25-yard line where Shane Chavis makes the catch there, and his team will have okay starting field position, but would have been a lot better if not for that great kick by Corbett.
Corbett had – that was a college-level punt right there. I'm impressed with Corbett and how well he's been kicking all day.
Yeah, I said it when he did it. I said, must be first kick jitters, and it has been because he's been great ever since.
That's an excellent job right there, getting good height on it, getting good depth, and it's causing guys – if this was a real game, that would have been a fair catch.
Today's game sponsored in part by Physio Control, St. Vincent Sports Performance, CVS Minute Clinic, Marriott, Field Turf, and Upper Deck. New quarterback into the game for the blue team. Handoff, trying to get to the outside. And brought down after a loss of two is Anthony Young, the running back out of Brooklyn, New York.
What's interesting, we talked about team defense and how well and aggressive the blue team has been playing defensively. The silver team defense has been swarming to the football. It's been 11 guys to the football, which is why you see team blue struggling offensively.
Chauncey Caldwell, the new quarterback in out of Durham, North Carolina, goes to Hillside. Has an offer from North Carolina Central. Has interest from Georgia Southern and Wake Forest. Both those squads, or at least definitely Georgia Southern, likes their quarterbacks a bit mobile. So we'll see if Caldwell shows off some of his wheels at some point during the game. Caldwell going to keep on the option. He's going to be wrapped up. Three, four defenders from the silver team back there to make the play. And again, right now, the defenses are winning the day, Emery.
As team defense, you have to be able to get 11 guys headed toward the football in the same direction. Pursuit angles have been excellent. That tells you these defensive linemen are getting off blocks. Linebackers have free rein to the football. They've done an excellent job of putting the kibosh on the offensive side, or both offenses for both teams.
Nate Bowditch with the first hit for the silver team. He's out of Old Mill in Severn, Maryland. So third, we'll call this one 17. Need to get it out to the 35-yard line for a first down. Caldwell going to roll to his right. Looks to throw it into the flat. This one's going to be caught. Big play here for Team Blue. Down the sidelines and dragged down at the 32-yard line goes the tight end Ethan Harris for a huge play to get his team out of a hole and into scoring position.
Good job by Ethan Harris keeping his eyes on the football to catch it, because what happened, you saw the defensive back you're going to see right here on the replay. This is why it's important to take proper angles to the ball. Now, defensive back undercuts it. Now, if you're going to take that chance, if you're going to gamble, you better come away with a pass breakup or an interception. He didn't. He missed it. It was a catch, and tight end was able to make a big play for Team Blue.
Yeah, you talked about it, how these coaches, the coaching staff had said that how big it's been a week for tight ends, and it's really we've seen the tight ends making huge plays throughout the days.
And that's a good bit of run after the catch skills right there, too. You know, you don't see tight ends nowadays being able to do it on both ends.
Caldwell looking to throw. That one's going to be incomplete. And that's going to take us to the end of the quarter. So our score, Team Silver 3, Team Blue 0. We'll be back with more right after this.
No one ever talks about the second quarter. It doesn't get a Nike commercial or a pregame speech. No one writes it on their wrist or on their shoe. There's no falling confetti, no kissing trophies. No breaks or halftime adjustments. Yet, it's the second quarter where you find your rhythm, your tempo, and the schemes that work. It's where you need determination to keep on grinding towards your goal, where you face adversity and rise above, where what matters isn't your critics, but the encouragement of your teammates and the words spoken by your coach. The second quarter is where you keep momentum after a fast start, where each person must continue to do his job every play, every down. It's where steadfast belief in your goal is paramount. Heads Up Football has started fast. 123,000 coaches have been certified. 60% of the game participates, but you don't change the culture of football overnight. It's now the second quarter. So with the ball in your hands, I ask you a simple question. What can we do next?
And Caldwell can be taken down at the line of scrimmage. So no gain on the play. This game brought to you by St. Vincent Sports Performance, the official sports medicine partner of the U.S. national team. Game also brought to you by Just Play Solutions. So going to be a third down and 11 here. Let's go ahead and set it down to our Jack Feely on the sidelines.
Jeremy, as is with football, emotions were high at the end of that first quarter on both sides of the field. Coach Testa's squad was a little bit jacked up and a little bit emotional at that they couldn't get any offense going. And on the other side, Coach Neugebauer was just trying to calm his team down. As is with football, emotions get a little tangled as the tackles go along, but the coaches did such a great job in reminding the kids that they're here to represent their country. This is a development camp first, and that they need to, cooler heads need to prevail. And thankfully, the coaches were there to remind them of that and remind them to say that if you need any motivation or if you need a cooler head to prevail, you need to look down again. As I said earlier in one of my reports, look at the letters USA. That should remind you why you're here. And most importantly, they said this about 10 times, each coach, you're here to have fun. Back to you.
And that kick, plenty of leg, and that kick is good.
And that had another 10 yards on it, if need be.
So another big kick.
Why you're here.
And again,
and most importantly, they said
we talked about it early on, after an early struggle, Kyle Corbett has been nothing but great. This thing would have been good from another 10 yards.
If I'm a college coach watching this game, which you should be because it's USA football and a lot of great talent, you have to watch this game. You know how bad teams struggle with the special teams department, and how, you know, you see the benefit of a Florida State kicker, Aguayo, making clutch kick after clutch kick. And if you can find a really good kicker, that's a guy you need to go after right away.
So first and 10 here. Suazo back in at quarterback for the silver team. Tries to hand it off to Magapinto. A little bit of a miscommunication there. Now Suazo going to try and get what he can get, but ends up getting thrown out of bounds at a 10-yard loss.
It looks like it's going to be tough sledding for teams wanting to go east and west in this ball game against these two defenses who have done a great job in beating you to the spot. So I think if they're going to have success, whether it be Team Silver or Team Blue, it's going to have to go downhill, because I don't think they can get anything done going on the outside on the perimeter.
3-3 game. Defenses have ruled the day so far. And if not for two wonderful kicks by kicker Kyle Corbett, might be scoreless right now. Suazo again facing a second and long here. Pump fakes. Now he'll go deep. Got a man, and it's complete. And first down yardage down the field to Jalen Riley.
I like what I've seen, what I'm seeing from Suazo, scanning the field. This is a guy that he went to the right side first initially, came all the way back to the left side of the field, and found the guy running down the seam, which was awesome. Right here, setting up right side, pump, coming back. That's a I don't want to say pro level, but that's a college level type read right there. That's a great job by the quarterback.
And also credit the offensive line for giving him plenty of time to scan that field. Suazo has the ball at the 39-yard line. Four wide receivers. Handoff, Magapinto up the middle. The short running back ends up lunging forward, getting himself a nice gain there across the 45-yard line, almost to the 47.
And I like how you see two good reads put next to each other. We saw the great passing read right there by Suazo, and now you're going to see the great run read. Again, on the read option, zone read, boom. Hands it off. The defensive backer was coming up hard, charging toward the quarterback. He gave the football. Magapinto was able to get the first down.
Second and two here. Again, four wide receiver sets. It's been the exclusive offense, and now a flag goes down. I believe it's going to be a delay of game, and it will be. First of those I think we've seen today, right?
Yes, the first delay of game I've seen, all game, since we've been here. But again, now we get to see Suazo once again scan the field with his passing. So it's gonna have to come downhill from these guys.
Take a look at our regional development camps brought to you by Sports Authority. We're Sports Authority, the official sporting goods provider of USA football. There's those stretched all the way back into February and to March as well. So a little bit different weather when the development camps are going on than these matchups. Curvin with a nice grab over the middle. Going to be about a four-yard gain, but showing off the hands in traffic.
Yeah, Curvin has done a great job so far blocking, and now he's showcasing the catching skills. And on the defensive side for Team Blue, Sean Roberts Jr. has been playing a heck of a football game. You're going to see right here on a replay, look at the placement right there by Suazo, extending out by Curvin to make the catch.
Third and three, we'll call it. Need to get the ball to the 49 for a first down. Four wide, so one of them Curvin, the big target at tight end. Magapinto in the backfield. Suazo, nice catch by Jalen Riley. Good enough for the first down, gets it by 2 yards.
Riley once again going up at his highest point to get the football to move the sticks. And again, you're throwing the ball to a covered guy, so you want to put it to where only he has a chance at it, and he has to make that play. And that was a great job right there by Riley.
So first down as the Silver team has something going here, a little bit of momentum with Derek Suazo at quarterback. Suazo, again, looks over the middle. Curvin goes through his hands, had a chance to pick it off. Number 7, Deontay Jones, couldn't bring it in either.
Curvin will want that pass back because he could have had that one. That would have been a big play for Team Silver. But, again, you see the live arm by Suazo, and I've been very impressed.
It's going to bring up a 2nd and 10 here. Curvin goes up top, joined by Gavin Welch. Agapinto, you're back in the backfield. He'll get the handoff. Looks to bounce a little bit, then cuts it back up the middle. Still on his feet, eventually brought down, but not until a gain of 5.
You want to see Graves Cribbs, the defensive lineman who broke through the offensive line on that play. You have to see him play with a little bit more control so that way he can make that tackle in the backfield. You're going to see on the replay, he had the opportunity to stop this for a minimal gain. Missed it right there. But again, good pursuit, nonetheless good pressure, but a good job by Magapinto.
So 3rd and 5 here. Need to get it to the 39 for a first down. Suazo in the shotgun. Going to swing it out. This one's going to be picked off, and this is going to be 6. Team Blue going to find the end zone first as Deontay Jones takes it the other way for a touchdown.
Deontay Jones caught that one. And here's the thing. We just praised Suazo about the good decision-making. This play was open initially when he looked at it. Then he tried to wait, hesitate for something bigger, came back to it, and that's what caused Jones to be able to recover, make a play heading downhill, pick it off, and bring it back for 6. You're going to see right here on the replay, the back is open right now on the swing. You want to throw it right there, but waits. Now you're throwing it late, and if you're late, it's going out of the way.
And that's going to be our play of the game presented by Shock Doctor. Again, our play of the game presented by Shock Doctor. And again, Deontay Jones with the big play there to put his team on the board. Extra point is good, and now Team Blue, just that quickly, when it looked like the momentum was going the Silver team's way, Team Blue snatches it right back on the pick 6 by Deontay Jones.
And that was a great play by Jones. Again, Jones reading the eyes of the quarterback, seeing where he wanted to go with the football. The back was open. If Suazo throws it now, the back is probably going to pick up the first down. He waits. Jones sees him, gets a chance to recover, and picks it off in stride and brings it back for 6.
Deontay Jones out of Fayetteville, North Carolina. Interesting tidbit on him. Jones attended the Randy Moss football camp a couple weeks ago, and Randy was there in attendance. And it was interesting that there were 10 guys, at least according to a newspaper story, that there were 10 guys that were chosen, I believe hand-selected by Randy, guys they thought really had some extra potential for a little private workout, if you will, a chance to kind of work a little bit closer with the future Hall of Fame wide receiver, and Jones was one of them. So obviously some folks have seen some potential, and I would have to think he's got to be sky high right now. Not just that, but you go through, you're at the USA football camp, you're doing well, you make plays like that, you have Randy Moss say, hey kid, you got something special. He's got to be feeling good about his football future.
I mean, listen, I would be on cloud 15 right now if that happened to me. And as a high school player, and to see one of the best in the game to single you out as someone that's doing exceptionally well, and already you're at a USA event.
Yeah, And you talk about that, your Team USA pathway brought to you by Sports Authority, the official sporting goods provider of USA football. Of course, things start off with your regional development camps, those that we showed you earlier on, and leads to the U.S. National Team Development Games. This contest, the last of five, had some in Canton, had some in College Station, Texas, also one in Los Angeles. Then you represent the U.S. in the international competition, the International Bowl, or the IFAF World Championship. Again, that's what these guys are kind of striving to get into that. Of course, the International Bowl will be played early next year. They play it down at Cowboys Stadium in Arlington, Texas.
And we saw the IFAF World Championships last week, Team USA taking home the gold medal.
So the silver team looking to go ahead and even things up after the pick six. Handoff, a little razzle-dazzle, possibly reverse pass, wide open down the field, and incomplete, but going to be pass interference as the two defenders for the blue team hustled their way down the field and just couldn't stop in time, but instead of giving up maybe 50, they give up 15.
There were two guys wide open on that play. Great play call at this juncture. It sucked in both safeties and got these guys flying up. You had two receivers running free. Pressure caused that ball to hang in the air. Otherwise, it would have been a big gain, like you mentioned.
Jalen Riley with the pass off the reverse. And that's going to go ahead. The intended target on that play was Jonathan Newman, the receiver out of Huntersville, North Carolina. So they re-spot the ball, and that's going to bring it out to the 35-yard line. First and 10. Back to throw out in the flat. That's going to be caught by Newman. He'll be brought down. Have first down yardage. Give him a gain of 14 as Newman takes the pass from Fitzsimmons and gets a good gain.
I love that play call on first down. Again, we've seen it throughout the course of these games. Easy pass completions on first down helps you move the sticks. You see right here a nice little comeback route. Set up, throw to the outside. Boom. Taking candy from a baby right there.
Quick pass out in the flat. This one well defended by the blue team. Great play by Jamel Wiggins to go ahead and make the quick tackle on Travell Calvin.
And Wiggins forced that play from the outset because he defeated the block by Jalen Riley, who's supposed to get that block on the outside guy and allow that play to work, but you saw what happened. Pressure bust pipes. I like saying that phrase because it's true. And that forced the receiver to then belly back and then was able to make the play. The defender was able to make the play.
Ball at the 42. Fitzsimmons going to be rushed, trying to get rid of it. He's going to be hit. Gets back close to the line of scrimmage. Still going to lose 2 yards. And right now, Emery, that blue defense is just getting after it.
Yeah, Luke Katera has done a great job out of Bristol, Wisconsin. That he essentially blew up that play because you're going to see right here on the replay, instant burst coming off the edge, coming from the anti-stunts side, forces him outside, nearly made the play, but slowed him up a bit to where everybody else get the play. I would mark Katera to make, in a stat book of the guy that got that assisted sack. That's a pressure right there.
Now, ball even farther back, the nose of it on the 40-yard line. Need to take it down to the 41 for a first down. They need 19 yards here on third down. Fitzsimmons going to throw it out in the flat. This one's incomplete. Making the lunging attempt was Newman. Couldn't bring it in, though. And that's going to lead to a punt for the silver team.
I like the aggressiveness, though. That was the play call we saw on first down, a deep comeback. And a better pass would have put him in position to make that play.
Again, Kyle Corbett on to punt. He's out of Pinehurst going into his senior year. And that's going to be a high kick. Great hang time. If this was not the modified special teams rules, that would probably have been no return at all for Shane Chavis, as it was just too high up in the air for anything. If you're recovering a punt, that's exactly what you want to see.
That was about a four-second hang time right there. It was impressive. Again, the punting has been outstanding.
Well, let you know that this game, thank our fine sponsors, including Flip Give, Gatorade, Sports Authority, Riddell, and Volt Athletic, also Siege Sports. First and 10, ball on the 11-yard line. Pump fake and rolling to the outside and trying to get some good yardage, actually getting a first down and some contact over at the sidelines just short of the sticks. Kyle DeOrio back in the game for Team Blue.
And this is why an athlete at quarterback is a good thing, because of what you can do once the framework of the play breaks down. He was able to make something out of nothing and got it down to where it's second and two now.
Good play there by DeOrio as we come up on the four-minute mark. Whole playbook open for Team Blue right now as they send three receivers to the right, one to the left. Handoff up the middle. Could be close, but I think just a yard gain on the play, so it's going to leave Team Blue short.
And what's interesting, you see where they're aligning Ethan Harris, a tight end out of Harrisburg, Virginia. He's in the slot. I think there's an opportunity here on this down, if they don't pick up the first, or let's say if they want to go deep down the field, I think he has an opportunity to split those safeties if they come back out with two deep. But he's aligned in the slot, tight to the line of scrimmage. And you see him right now. Now he's on the line of scrimmage. Be interested to see if they just try to pick this up or try to attack in the passing game.
Fumbled snap, and it's going to be a Team Blue player getting on top of it. So heads-up play to keep it from getting back in good position for Team Silver. Believe that was Dunbar, the running back, jumping on top of that low snap. And that's going to bring up a fourth down, though, and we'll see a timeout. And interestingly, because of the way the teams are set up, with the on both on the same side of the field, their huddles are literally 5 yards away from each other.
I wonder if they're listening to each other talk and a little bit of...
And that's going to... We'll sit at the break real... Let's actually go to keep it right here, Emery. Sorry for cutting you off there at your point.
No, I was just saying, it's just to, you know, tie up that point. Wonder if they're listening a little bit to what each other is saying. These guys have been practicing all week, so I'm pretty sure there's a little bit of commonality going on between the two squads.
Yeah, and interesting, I think that Team Silver taking that time out just to go ahead and, save time for their own drive possibility. That's probably why the two teams weren't really concerned about it, as we'll see Corbett come on and punt it again. Another nice tail wagger this time. It's going to be caught right at the 45-yard line by Justin Terry. But it's probably, if it wasn't the modified kicking rules, we would see the two teams, at least you wouldn't see it, one, because it wouldn't be on the same side of the field, but there'd be a little more secrecy there because you don't know, is it a punt block coming? Is that type of thing? You don't want to let that up, but here, where again, it's the catch it, punt it, that type of thing, you're okay by letting the other team on your plan. So Team Silver going to have a chance here with 2:16 left to go in the half to get an evening up score, or possibly going ahead and getting a field goal to cut it down as they look for the win here in our third game of the day here at the USA Football 2015 Development Games here in Baltimore, Maryland. Handoff up the middle. Good run. Good chance here for Team Silver. First down yardage by DeMarcus Ramsey.
And DeMarcus Ramsey is the first back we've seen in the three games we've been here that's a bigger back. He looks about a good 5'11", 225, a big back going downhill with some speed. That's a good thing to have. And that's, he was able to pick up a chunk play and move the sticks as we go into the two-minute mark.
DeMarcus Ramsey out of South County High School down in Lorton, Virginia. And one of his things that he said in the profiles was he wants to be on an East Bay cover, not Sports Illustrated, East Bay. But he's going to get a gain of one here, and that's going to go ahead and keep the chains. They'll probably have to take a timeout here, which they will. The Silver Squad's going to go ahead and take one of their timeouts and stop the clock as we approach the 90-second mark here in the half. Let's take a quick break. We'll be back with more after this from Towson.
This is where games are played, where friendships are forged, where kids come to have fun and character takes shape. This is where coaches teach fundamentals, where respect is both learned and earned, where entire communities come together, where the game happens once a week, but the lessons learned last a lifetime.
This is where the name on the front of the jersey matters more than the one on the back. Where champions are made in the fourth quarter. And memories last long after the clock reaches zero. This is USA Football.
Welcome back to Johnny United's Field here at Towson University. As the Silver Team has got something going here, a nice drive going and a nice pass there as Derek Suazo hitting Keith Freeman in stride for another long gain down inside the 30-yard line, right down the 25.
Great play coming out of a timeout, the quick slant, the skinny post, whatever you want to call it, but a completion and a big play in the passing game. You see down at the bottom of the screen, the first guy clears with a bubble, opens up a big passing window, completion, moves the sticks.
First and 10, Suazo going to the end zone, and this one's going to be picked off. Interception for Team Blue as Jamel Wiggins makes the play. And again, a little bit too bold, and Team Blue makes Team Silver pay for it.
Excellent job by Wiggins to not only turn and find the football, but attack it at its highest point. That's textbook right there. That's fundamentals. That's technique. You see right there, Salza was feeling himself, got the bounce in the step, took a chance, paid for it.
So another good defensive play, and at this point, Tony Testa has to be very happy with what his defense has put out there on the field. Interesting to see what tack Team Blue will take here with 1:10 left to go.
Yeah, Team Blue is taking on the personality of defensive coordinator Markel Harrison out of West Virginia Wesleyan. They're playing aggressive football right now, and it's paying off.
Handoff up the middle. Minimal gain. Price still back into the game for Team Blue. And clock continues to run, so I think both teams at this point content. Just kind of play it out. We'll see, though, if Team Silver decides to take a timeout here. So still in the shotgun. Three wide receivers in the tight end. He's going to throw it out quick, out into the flat. And again, good play by the defense of Team Silver is coming up and making a stop on L.D. Edwards.
Looks like Isaiah Hall out of Walnut, California, West Coast guy, getting in the mix.
Haven't seen many of those, but we have seen a few. And it's been a pretty impressive showing in this one by the Team Blue defense as they lead 10-3 here at the half at Towson in the USA Football 2015 development games. And it's been a definitely a defensive struggle, Emery.
Absolutely. And you look at the defensive line of Team Blue doing a great job staying aggressive, playing on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage, and on the back end, the saying goes the front end helps the back end, and that secondary has paid huge dividends because of the work their defensive line has put together.
Yeah, and again, we haven't seen an offensive touchdown yet, but we have seen good defense. We have seen great kicking by Kyle Corbett as well. Let's send it down to our Jack Feely, who's standing by with a special guest.
Thanks very much, Jeremy. I'm down here with Stacy Feltz of St. Vincent Sports Performance. Stacy, how many years have you been involved with St. Vincent and USA Football?
I personally have been with St. Vincent Sports Performance for about 8 years and working with USA Football, traveling the International Bowl and whatnot for about 3 years.
And what kind of talk about the experience that you've been involved with USA Football, how it's benefited you, but also what you've learned along the way.
I've been able to travel a ton, which has been really fun, seeing different cities and meeting kids from all over the country, which has been really great. And it's really fun whenever you get a kid at one event and you see him a couple years later at another event and they're like, hey, we know you, we've seen you forever. So it's really fun to watch them grow in the game and help keeping them safe and then helping them if they do get injured, seeing them on the return side. And it's really fun to keep up with them during the school year too.
Talk about the preventative measures you take towards keeping these kids safe. Obviously, like all football-related activities, they want to keep the kids safe and avoid getting injuries. What kind of preventative measures do you take in terms of getting set for a game?
Right, absolutely. This week alone, with the heat that we've had out here in Baltimore, we've made sure that we have a cool tub on in case we have any heat injuries, heat illness, making sure that we are keeping the kids hydrated. We hold them if there's an issue. We try to keep them in check health-wise and make sure that we're not setting them up for a failure this week or back whenever they get into the season, back when they get back home.
And the relationship with USA Football, how has it benefited you personally in terms of your growth as an athletic trainer?
Getting to work with a wide variety of injuries and of kids, I will say it absolutely has taken me to a different level, being able to work with more elite kids. The kids that you work with at home, you have all kinds of varieties, but these kids are all over the country. They're some of the best kids that are out there, and it's really fun, and you see a lot of different things.
Well, Stacey, great job for keeping the kids safe. Thanks so much.
Thanks.
Back to you guys.
Thank you, guys. We'll take a quick break right now. We'll be back with more right after this.
Big thing they talk about, you know, football doesn't create character, it exposes it.
Character is demonstrated in tough times. That's when you really find out what true character is.
In life, you get knocked down. You know, life's not peaches and cream pie in the sky. You know, there's times when the bottom falls out, and so you have to respond.
The guys that have great character are the guys that we trust, and I tell them, those are the guys that I put on the field.
You know, I'm looking for humble young men in recruiting that when they're off the field, they're a gentleman, and when they step on the field, they're a warrior and an animal.
Look at the character, number one, because that's what will come out over time. His attitude, his work ethic will show up over his character. And sometimes I can fool you, but usually character is what you're doing when nobody's watching.
It's how you approach every day, how you approach every workout, every practice, every game. When the attitude is right, not just from one person, but from a team, you know you've got something special.
When I think back on my experience growing up, the most influential people in my life were my teachers and my coaches.
To me, the important thing is the influence that you have on young people.
You're responsible not just to teach him to block and tackle, and not just to teach him, to win, and not just have a good time, but yet become a real person in all areas of his life.
Guys that have great character, that work hard, that do what they're supposed to do, that's what all good teams are founded on.
Welcome back to Towson University here at Johnny United Stadium. You see these wonderful overhead views that we're bringing you today that we've been able to kind of get throughout the week. Really some fantastic stuff. Want to let you know that this game today brought to you by Marriott, the official hotel partner of USA Football and the U.S. national teams. Today's contest also brought to you by Field Turf, the official field building grant partner of USA Football. And again, a nice look here earlier in the week from overhead at here at Towson University. A wonderful shot that we were able to get, and really a good one. And you see the shot currently today as we sit at the half with a score of 10-3, Team Blue leading Team Silver in what's been a defensive battle throughout. Jeremy Huber, Emery Hunt, back here with you here at Towson. And again, Emery, it goes without saying that really the defenses have been the stars of this third game.
You want to say, because, you know, when you look at an offense, it takes time to get things right. But defensively, it's about reacting. It's about playing aggressive and playing smart. And they've done all three. Both teams have. And that's why their defense has shown itself in the first half.
Yeah, and we've really seen it's almost the it's the Marty Schottenheimer special in this one, defense and special teams. And really, you talk about it, what's been great, David Corbett, the kicker for both teams, had the two long field goals. He's really been impressive today, too.
Yeah, he's been kicking the heck out of the football, sky kicks, directional kicks, getting good depth on his kicks. I've been very impressed.
And again, really a good game today that we've seen so far. And it's again, we're hoping for a little more offense in the second half. Want to let you know that this contest also brought to you by Upper Deck, the official trading card partner of USA Football and the U.S. national teams. This contest also brought to you by Volt Athletic, the official strength and conditioning solutions partner of the U.S. national team. Both squads back on the field. The blue squad on offense first. The gray squad, excuse me, the silver squad, back on defense first. And that's how we'll start things off. Our final two quarters of the day as this one a 10-3 lead by Team Blue on Team Silver. And Emory, you got to wonder, is Team Blue, they can get something going on offense. Obviously, that's going to give them a nice advantage in this contest.
Well, the way their defensive line has played, being aggressive, you want to see that offensive line get a little bit more aggressive, a little bit more nasty up front to start firing off the football so that way the ground game can get going. If they can run the football, they can close out this game.
Still a long way to go, but again, if we haven't seen much offense out of anybody, and that defensive touchdown by Deontay Jones really could give Team Blue a cushion if they're able to go ahead and find a way to score. Handoff to Chavis. He's going to be brought down in the backfield. Nice play there by Nathaniel Bowditch.
And Bowditch did a great job exploding, finding the ball carrier, and then bringing him down. You couldn't draw it up better for a guy coming out of Severn, Maryland.
Out of Old Mill High School. Pretty good program over there when it comes to Maryland public school football. That's a loss of five on the play, so brings up a second and 15. Need to take it out to the 35 for a first down. Quick pass out to Chavis. He's going to fumble that one. Will it stay in bounds? Will be picked up. They'll say he stays in bounds, and a defensive touchdown the other way. This time for Team Silver is Aiden Brown able to scoop that one up and take it for six.
You couldn't coach that better, because that's very tough to do, to scoop and score. And Aiden not only was able to scoop the ball up, but keep his feet in bounds. And you saw a great play by the receiver, made the catch, Shane Chavis out of Baltimore. Wanted to do a little bit extra, make the guy miss, and he broke the first tackle, but you got to secure the football. Great strip right there by the corner, and we saw Aiden pick it up and scoop and score for the touchdown. Now we have a tie ball game potentially.
Yeah, getting that hand in and punching the ball loose, and now Corbett on to kick the extra point. That one nice and easy for Corbett, and again, we're all tied up. And, folks, we have not had an offensive score in this game. We've had two defensive scores, and, boy, they've been exciting.
I mean, when you talk about defense making the play, it's been defense and special teams because of the punts, you know, backing guys up, and now defense making the play, two touchdowns by both squads as far as, like, defensive touchdowns total. This has been a well-played defensive game. Which offense steps up now in the third quarter could ultimately determine who wins this matchup.
You would think it would have to play a big role, as somebody is going to have to find a way to get something going on the offensive end. But the way these two defenses have played, I don't know. At first, it was they were just stopping the offenses. Now they're scoring on their own.
And this is something we haven't seen all day. We haven't seen the defenses score points, and we've seen two defensive touchdowns. This has been exciting to see the defenses come alive. And we've seen great defensive play, but not like this.
First and 10 for the blue team. Quick pass out in the flat. That one a little bit dangerous as he was looking to get it out to Isaiah Marshall in the corner. Closed quickly. Luckily, maybe went for the tackle instead of going for the ball.
And that's the point I was going to make. If he would have kept his eyes up and looked at the ball, he would have picked it off and probably scored again, because this was a soft throw going to the far side of the field. Could have been an interception.
Price still back in at quarterback. Actually attended the Manning Passing Academy earlier this year. Handoff up the middle, and Eric Jung going to be stopped for a minimal gain. Jung, a guy, Emory, who's got himself really a good academic background. We talked about some of the guys here. Wants to go study medicine. Actually has a 3.99 unweighted GPA. Once you put the weights on it, it becomes a 4.03.
That's a great job in the classroom, and coaches like to hear that guys get it done in the classroom and also on the field.
Third and 10. Quick pass out. This one's going to be complete, but a good tackle there to keep Stanley Jenkins from getting to the first down.
We've seen a lot of good tackles in this ball game.
Fourth and 2 here for the blue team, and they're going to go ahead and go for it. And we'll see if they go ahead and get it. Handoff up the middle. It's going to be very, very close. I think he might just be short. We'll see once they bring the chains in.
You know who made that play and who has been having a really good game? That's Ryan Casey, the defensive lineman out of Colchester, Vermont. Big defensive tackle doing a great job in clogging the lane. He's been playing well so far.
And that's going to be a turnover on downs, and we'll see the play right here.
It's all about creating a mashup. It's all about creating a pile so your linebackers have free reign to the football. And if you're able to clog up a running lane, clog up a gap, you're going to force that running back to do something outside of what he wants to do, which is run freely, and that's how they made the play. Sets up this first down on the short end of the field for Team Silver. This is what you have to want if you're an offensive coach.
Quick pass. That's going to be a big play here, getting down. And for Team Silver, Jonathan Newman going to get first down yardage. Before we go on any further, Emery, want to go ahead and issue a quick correction. Someone sent it on Twitter. LD Edwards, one of the folks playing in this contest on the blue team, actually his graduation year going to be 2017, not 2016. So we want to apologize for that. And the folks that are corrected us, thank them for tuning in.
We really appreciate that. I mean, guys out there watching us do our thing as these guys are out here competing at a high level.
Going to pull it and going to be a touchdown, an offensive score as getting into the end zone. Connor Fitzsimmons out of Brooklyn, New York, struts his way into the end zone for the score to put his team up by six, extra point pending.
Great read on the zone read right there. Again, a lot of times you want to see guys force a defensive man on the line of scrimmage to commit. Defensive end commits, free lane right there for Fitzsimmons to waltz into the end zone.
That's going to bring Corbett on. And Corbett's kick is up and good. So we ask for an offensive touchdown. We get an offensive touchdown. And Emery, maybe more importantly, we've got two touchdowns in the first 2 minutes of the third quarter.
Exactly. And this is we haven't seen games, you know, explode with points so far. This may be the one that starts to explode because offenses are now playing with confidence. The defense inspired them. And now you see this offensive play here could be a sign of bigger things to come. And if I'm Corbett, the way he's kicking the football, he may not leave Towson without I don't know what their kicking situation is, but this is a guy that's been doing extremely well.
Who knows? We get to kind of kick into the bowl end of the stadium, so there's no kind of wind whistling through. So not be a bad place to do your kicking. Fumbled snap on the ground still. And eventually, player from the blue team is going to jump on top of that one. Anthony Young, the running back, going to get on it. And we've seen that a few times where guys just, you know, that seems like to me the basic part of the game is just making sure you look that snap in.
Exactly. It goes to show you that a lot of times when you're out there, you tend to think of too many things when you're just supposed to focus on your task. That's a simple task, and that's show you the quarterback probably saw something in the secondary and want to get the football out of his hands quickly, but you have to get the snap first in order for that to happen.
Kyle DiOrio back in at the quarterback spot. Has four wide receivers, three down low, one up top. DiOrio passes. That one's going to be behind the receiver, incomplete as he was trying to hook up with LD Edwards.
Placement is everything. You got to put that ball on the inside of the receiver so he can catch it and run. Right now, with that play, you stop the receiver in his tracks. Only certain situations you want to do that. Not in that situation where they're sitting in a soft cover two shell, inviting the inside play. You have to throw that ball hard, quick, and that way he can make a play after the catch.
DiOrio over the middle. This one's incomplete. That one was intended for Scott Scherzer out of New Jersey. Coverage on the play by Keith Jackson.
Keith Jackson showing a little bit of emotion out there. You like to see that from your defensive guys after a big stop. You earned the right to make that play. You celebrate with your team, and that's exactly what they did. Now they force a three and out.
And so a chance for Team Silver to go ahead and put some quick points on the board, kind of on back-to-back possessions here after getting the score. They get the defensive play. They get the offensive play. Now a chance really to put a lot of points up on the board. But again, Corbett comes up with a wonderful punt all the way inside the 20-yard line to flip field position.
And that was a six-second hang time. I made sure to count it this time. That ball was in there 6 seconds. That's impressive.
Corbett is getting it done today. and showing his worth. Again, as you said, if you're not watching the USA football, you need to be. And if you need a punter at the collegiate level, keep an eye on this guy.
My goodness, that's a heck of a punt. Let's see, 8:07 when the ball is in the air, and about time it lands.
And that's on fast forward.
That's on fast forward. Yeah. Right. That is, wow.
Yeah, it was a another wonderful punt. And like we said, had that first not very good kick, and after that, he's been great. Magapinto up the middle. He's going to be brought down after a gain of 4.
Magapinto runs hard, and you like to see that from your backs. It seems like guys that are shorter backs, smaller backs, come in with an attitude, and I don't mind that attitude, and it's showing right here how he's running the football.
Magapinto won multiple Massachusetts Player of the Year awards in 2014, Western Massachusetts Player of the Year awards in 2014. Also ran for over 4,000 yards over the last two seasons combined.
That is insane. That's nuts right there. And that's showing he's getting the job done, which is why he's in this game.
He's flanking Derek Suazo. Magapinto gets the handoff, spinning forward, getting positive yardage again. Another gain of 3 on the play. So that's going to take it up to the 23-yard line. Need to get it to the 26 for a first down.
It's tough to get a good shot on him. I mean, he's probably what, 5'6", 5'7"? It's tough to get a good hit on him. And, you know, low center of gravity, you don't knock him over. You knock him to the side. He's breaking a lot of tackles.
Actually getting a save and better gain. So it's going to set up a 3rd and 2 here. 4 wide receivers set. Suazo in the gun. Player jumps for Team Blue, and we'll see if he was drawn. They'll say no. That's encroachment. Interesting. One side judge said it was he went with the encroachment signal, while the referee quickly gave the false start signal.
And you saw the defensive lineman, as Sean Roberts Jr. out of Fort Washington, Maryland, give his teammate some dap, saying like, hey. Was able to draw him off sides, draw the false start, and I backed him up as 3rd and 7.
So definitely changes up the play call for Adam Neugebauer. And now we'll have a timeout, and the Tony Testa's squad going to take that timeout and talk about what they're going to see from Team Silver here and exactly what they'll be looking at when they come out of this huddle. This game is sponsored by FlipGive, an official fundraising partner of USA Football. Also sponsored by Gatorade, the official sports fuel provider of USA Football. It's been a hot day out here, but not too bad. Of course, we're in the air conditioning, so we don't know for sure. But
the greatest invention in life history has been the air conditioning.
It's up there. It's definitely up there. It's not good to be in if you're training for football, though. I learned that the hard way one year. Not good. You want to make sure you're outside in the heat if you're going to be practicing in the heat.
Exactly.
These guys have no problem with that. They've been all over America getting ready for these games and for their high school football seasons later on in the year. 3rd and 7. Need to get it to the 26 for a first down. Suazo rushed. He's going to lose it. This one could be another defensive score. It will be. Jumping on the fumble will be number 17, Gregory Smalls, and we have a chance to be all tied up again with our 3rd defensive touchdown of the game.
I'm smiling ear to ear because you see how aggressive defense leads to positive plays. You see right here coming off the edge with a little bit of pressure, a little blitz, and that's a fumble. That he hits him in the back, ball comes out, and they recover for a touchdown in the end zone. You like the aggressiveness, and that's what gets you points right now, and they're doing a great job getting points.
Caleb Slaughter with the hit to knock that ball loose. And Team Silvernight putting their defense out there. This one's going to go up and no good.
Well.
So Corbett misses the extra point, so he won't be tied up. That's a tough one when the guy, same guy's kicking for both teams, and he's kicked so well, but just missed that one, so we will not be tied up here. So we'll see if that adds a little wrinkle and intrigue to this contest. But back to that last play, Emery, when you look at it, and the guy who jumps on it, Gregory Smalls out of Land O'Lakes, Florida, goes to Town and Country Christian Academy, very small school, plays 6-on-6 football.
Wow. Wow, and that's something I remember seeing, and we were probably the same age back when we were in high school. Only a few teams had that 6-on-6 football, but you see right here, blitz, empty backfield, so the quarterback has to get rid of that football quickly. You know the blitzing guy is your guy. You're responsible for him, so you have to get rid of that football. He held it a little bit too long, tried to belly outside the pocket, got hit, fumbled, touchdown, blue team.
6-on-6 football down in Florida. And I know you have 8-on-8 out west, 7-on-7 some places in West Texas and Wyoming and some of the less populated states, but never heard of 6-on-6, and kind of Smalls was interviewed for the piece. As we see this quick pass out to John Kervin, is going to go ahead and get good yardage near the sticks. But he had said, look, it's kind of, it basically makes you a better defensive back and wide receiver because of the fact it takes away most of the inside of the field.
Exactly, and I'll give you one more tidbit that you're probably not ready for. You know who else played 6-on-6 football and won the Heisman Trophy?
Nope.
Rashawn Salaam played 6-on-6. I'm chock full of these things right now, man.
You are chock full of tidbits right now, and good ones at that. Back into the game, Fitzsimmons, and this one is going to be another false start on Team Silver.
Nice catch, by the way, on the last play by the tight end. Good safe play to come out of a turnover to have and move the sticks. But now you get yourself set back with the false start. So.
Yeah, we talked about it. We saw in the first game of the day, Kyle Bilodeau played on Danny Cowgill's squad, and, of course, John Kervin playing on this squad. They're both at Woodbury Forest. Bilodeau really played JV ball last year, expected to be part of the varsity squad. They're going to have a good tight end core. This one's going to be caught over the middle. Tough catch made by Travell Calvin, and that's going to be close to the sticks on third down, and they're going to go ahead and move the chains.
Good job right there by Travell Calvin. Why? Because he fought through the contact, and that's what you want from a receiver. Be a little bit more physical. We saw a play similar like this in the Super Bowl where the receiver may have stopped on a route, causing the defensive back to undercut him. He fought through that route and made the tough catch. Move the sticks.
First and 10. Need to get it out to the 45-yard line for a first down. Handoff up the middle. The big battering ram out here today, DeMarcus Ramsey, with a nice run. Give him 8 on the play.
I think Ramsey has made his claim to get some more carries because of what he's bringing to the table. He's downhill. He's a power guy. And we know defensive players, especially at the second and third levels, won't want to keep tackling this man as the game goes on.
So second and 2 here. And Ramsey's going to stay in the game alongside Fitzsimmons, 4 wide receivers. Fitzsimmons, hands off, gives on the option. And Ramsey again kind of pushing his way through and ends up getting a 5-yard gain for a first down.
And now what you start to see is that running back groove you get in once you get consistent carries. Now you feel out the defense. Now you understand where guys are attacking. And you also see from field level, as a back, you see where guys are getting tired. You know, the heat's kicking in and you're ready to get going. You're revved up, and now you'll be able to take advantage of the defense.
Quick pass, Fitzsimmons, incomplete as he looked for Jonathan Newman, just let it get through his hands.
Yeah, Newman probably kept an eye on that defensive back, squeezing the lane right there. You got to make sure you keep your eyes focused on the football. Catch it, then make your move.
Gets the replay here.
He passed up the swing route. The swing route was there on the bubble. And tried to take a chance with the deep pass. Could have worked out the skinny post, but you got to make the catch.
Interesting blocking scheme up on front on that one. See guys kind of crossing the line of scrimmage. That one almost intercepted. Going down low to try and pick it off the ground was Jamel Wiggins. Couldn't do it. And again, we've seen defense make plays all day. One more wouldn't have been a surprise.
And we saw Wiggins make that interception in the end zone, by the way. I want to say maybe close to halftime, made the big play in the end zone to stop a drive by Team Silver.
So third down now, 3rd and 10. So they'll look to get it to the 41-yard line for a first down. Under the 4-minute mark here in the third quarter, as Team Silver holding a one-point lead on Team Blue after a missed extra point. Fitzsimmons going to throw this one up. Incomplete, and closest guy to it was Deontay Jones, who had the pick six earlier in the game, was trying for his second interception of the game.
Yeah, he had to get on his horse on that one and get to the far hash, to the sideline, and make a play. Almost was able to come away with the interception.
So now Corbett back on to punt. He's got a lot of work today with that leg between field goals and extra points and punts and another good kick. And this one's going to bounce and check up. And what a kick there again by Kyle Corbett. Just took a left turn, goes out of bounds at the 9-yard line. So again, Team Blue will be in the shadow of their own goal line.
See the replay here. Great technique. Great form, follow through with the kick, and to get it to die where he wants it to die and bounce laterally, that's impressive.
And that's one of the big differences that we'd have to think with the field turf artificial surface as opposed to the old AstroTurf, more of a carpet, if you will, where ball, you can actually get it to kind of react more like grass than back in the old days where a ball like that is going to roll into the end zone.
Exactly.
Hand off up the middle. Maybe a minimal gain on that play as they gave it off to Amadou Dunbar.
The defensive ends of Team Silver are doing a great job getting off blocks and condensing gaps. And what that does, it makes the lanes smaller for the back to get through, and that's why they've been able to make plays on these read option, not read option, but zone read plays.
Second down here. Team Blue breaks the huddle. Chauncey Caldwell back into the game. Caldwell throws it out into the flat. That's a catch and brought down about 3 yards short of first down yardage, the running back Anthony Young.
And you see that Caldwell has a lot of schools looking at him. They're going to get a good quarterback wherever he decides to go. He has a live arm. He's decisive when he throws a football. I like what I've seen so far from him.
Correction on that play, actually catch made by L.D. Edwards, the product of Friendship Collegiate in Washington, D.C. A lot of guys from Friendship playing at this these three games today here at Towson. Third down, keep around the end, first down yardage. Good play there by Caldwell to keep the chains moving.
A little bit of patience, a little bit of athleticism, a little bit of speed, all on display right there by Caldwell to get the first down.
Today's game brought to you in part by Physio Control, St. Vincent Sports Performance, CVS Minute Clinic, Marriott, Field Turf, and Upper Deck. We'll see here again Caldwell showing off that speed we talked about that we thought he had, getting outside and getting the first down, setting up a first and 10 here. This one out in the flat. Chavis makes the catch. He hit and brought down, drags a tackler, and he'll have a first down on a gain of 11.
I like Chavis. And outside from the fumble he had earlier where he was trying to do the same thing he did just now, but you see him having the ability to make that first guy miss and do a great job of getting positive yards, push that shoulder down, and was able to power through for the first down.
So Caldwell, completion there for the first down. Clock rolling towards the one-minute mark here in the third quarter. Hand off, no keep. Caldwell around the end, showing some wheels. He'll be brought down out across the 40-yard line. Mark him down in between the 43 and the 44. And we talked about it, Emery, that Caldwell's getting looks from Georgia Southern. They don't take guys or statues in the pocket.
And Willie Fritz does a great job with that spread option attack right there. Sunbelt Conference football causing problems. You see right here. And he may not be the fastest, but he has good enough speed to get it done. And also shows a little toughness right there, taking on a tackler. Gets up, amped up. And that's how you're supposed to be when you make a good play like that. Look at him, amped up.
Yeah, definitely. And the way this game is going, it's about big plays. And right now, a timeout on the field. So we'll be right here, of course, we'll be coming up at the end of the quarter. And again, it's kind of been just a complete difference where the defenses were completely dominant. Now, again, we've seen defensive touchdowns, but the offenses have gotten the ball moving a little bit here in the second half and looked better than they did in the first.
And we've seen the offense start to take on the mindset of the defensive side of the ball, which has been aggressive all game.
Want to let you know that this game brought to you by Siege Sports, the official uniform provider of the U.S. national teams. Today's game also brought to you by Physio Control, official AED provider of USA football. So actually, that's going to be the end of the quarter. So with that, see, we're going to the clock. They must have had a malfunction there, as didn't we went from a minute to nothing. So let's get to a quick break. We'll be right back after this.
I got plans.
Woo! I'm going places.
Here I come.
I got plans to pick myself up.
I will gain trust.
I'm gonna earn everything I get.
I got plans to command your respect.
I've got plans to push my limits.
Guilty, but another great run by Caldwell there. Again, Emery getting on the outside, and he's been a guy who's been able to go ahead and get it done with his legs, especially the last few possessions.
He's in his zone right now. He's amped up. He was amped up on that last play, took a break, came back after the fourth quarter started, and ripped off a big gain for Team Blue. Now their offense is knocking on the door. Can they punch it in and take a lead?
So first down here for Caldwell. As he'll go ahead and off tackle, and he'll be brought down for a minimal gain. Folks, want to let you know what happened there. We were coming out and actually had a minute left on the clock, and then all of a sudden the game just kind of went to the fourth quarter, and then they ran a play. So we were in commercial break, got out of it as soon as we could, and showed you the tail end of the Caldwell run. And again, he's really showing off right now. Again, we talked about it. It's a guy who's some programs who like their quarterbacks mobile, or some teams that are looking at him, and Caldwell obviously showing that in this game today. Now showing off his arm. This one's going to be complete. LD Edwards with the catch for a four-yard gain. Let's get down the sidelines, and Jack.
Thanks very much, Jeremy. At the end of that third quarter, I had a chance to actually grab head coach Tony Testa and just get his thoughts on his team's overall performance. And he said he's really happy with the defensive performance. As you can see, they've had two defensive scores. And the one thing that I asked him heading into the fourth that he wanted to improve was obviously his offense. But he said that with just a week to really work with his offensive players, he wasn't really expecting much. So he told me, I asked him if he had, I pressed him a little bit more, and he said, well, the two things that we want to focus on are focus and finishing. And as you can see, they're driving down the field with pretty much fluidly right now. Back to you.
Thank you, Jack. Another flag's going to go down. Caldwell was very close to first down yardage, but he was about a yard short, but then a flag comes in, and we'll see, maybe a late hit.
Looked like a block in the back because it came from the far side of the field, rough threw it across the field. And unnecessary because, again, he had the first down. If you don't see his numbers in the front, don't block him.
That's going to move it all the way back, and the blue team needing just a field goal to go ahead and take the lead back. Not something they want to give up. 10 yards, really, of field position they give up on that block in the back. So we'll see what they do here. Again, Caldwell with a pretty good drive going for Team Blue. We'll see if he can convert here. Looking at a third and 10, needs to take it down to the 16-yard line.
Big opportunity right here in the slot with the tight end.
And a snap. It's going to go wild. Caldwell picks it up, looks to throw it away, and he's going to get swarmed under back at the 45-yard line and knocked out of field goal position, coming up and making a big play there, Ashanti Brown.
The little things, they matter a whole lot. You know, it's interesting when you see that play. It had potential from the start. Tight end was wide open, like I mentioned earlier, before the snap. But you see right here on the replay, misplaced snap causes everything to throw off, and now you take the sack because if you throw it away, you're going to get intentional grounding.
So that's going to go ahead and force a punting situation. Corbett will come on. That's going to be a high kick, and they'll let it bounce, and it's going to roll into the end zone, so that'll bring it back out. where it could have been another one that died right there, and it didn't go far into the end zone, just enough. Luckily for Team Silver, as they'll go ahead and get decent field position to go ahead and start their drive.
And that's one of those drives where you circle where it's a big opportunity, a missed opportunity to put points on the board, whether it's three or a touchdown. They blew a chance right there because of a bad snap.
So now we saw in our last game, the Silver team with a small lead late in the game went on a drive that kind of put the game away. We'll see if this Silver team can do the same. Derek Suazo out on the field at the quarterback spot for Team Silver. Going to hand it off, off right tackle, and stacked up is running back Kobe Smith. He'll get maybe minimal yards on the play, maybe even lost a bit.
Yeah, you want to see if they can punch this in, and like we said earlier, wind this clock down, you know, go on that 5 to 6 minute drive to where you put the pressure on Team Blue to try to maximize their few possessions that they have left in this game.
So no gain on the play. Brings up a 2nd and 10. Coming up on the 8:30 mark to go in regulation. Smith hitting the backfield twice, does a great job just to go ahead and lunge forward for a 2 yard gain.
I tell you what, man, that defensive line of Team Blue, and this is what I saw yesterday from Coach Lee Rose from Butler University, coaching these guys up. They're aggressive, they were having fun, but they were getting coached up, they were getting taught the proper way, and they haven't gotten tired. They're deep. They've rotated a lot of guys up front, and everyone that's come in has made a play.
A play going to be need to be made here for Team Silver. They have a 1 point lead. Suazo gets the low snap. Now he's going to go ahead and pitch it forward, Brett Favre style. He's going to have first down yardage, getting it out to Kobe Smith. Smith able to make the catch, and credit Suazo for some improvisation skills, I should say, and Kobe Smith for being ready on the play.
I mean, staying calm in the face of pressure, whether it's coming from a blitzer or just from a fumble snap thrown off play. He got pressure instantly up the middle and was able to stay calm, found the open guy, and got it to him by any means necessary.
And it's funny, Suazo's pick six he threw earlier, you said it, he waited too long on the play. That time, he saw Kobe Smith open, his brain processes, he's got enough room for the first down, and he said, get it to him.
Get it to him. I don't care if I throw it underhand, get it to him.
1st and 10 for Team Silver, and a flag's going to go down, and they're going to say false start. Made a delay of game, actually. So definitely have seen more flags thrown in this game than our previous two.
And the second delayed game we've seen in out of all three games.
So that's going to move it back 5 yards, put it back at about the 37-yard line. Coming up on the 7-minute mark to go here. Suazo brings him out. Magopinto back in the game. They'll hand it off to Magopinto, trying to get to the outside, flag down in the middle of the field. Magopinto skips out of bounds, but this is going to come back. And again, the yellow hankies really starting to slow down the offense for the Silver Squad.
And this is a little tip-off we've seen just from up here. The last series or two, the backs have been aligned alongside of the quarterback. Magopinto comes into the game. He's back behind the quarterback, which sort of tips off that, okay, he's getting the football. They're going to run this one, and Team Blue wasn't fooled.
Maybe some good coaching or good football intuition by the Blue team to make sure that they weren't out of position, maybe knew what that play was coming. So now a 2nd and very long. Need to get it all the way out to the 48-yard line of the Blue team for a first down. Suazo rolls out. Big play there. He's going to go and get it a lot of that yardage back out across the 40-yard line. So a nice gain by Team Silver.
Nice throw, soft throw over on the move over the middle of the field. It hits the receiver in stride. He protects the receiver with the placement of the ball and also did a great job just throwing on the move.
So we're going to have a quick stoppage here as one of the players is down. And we see the replay. Again, a nice completion. And again, getting that to a 3rd and least plausible at a 3rd and 10. as opposed to where they were back at their own 24-yard line.
That's just a good play, coming off play action, little half roll out, little waggle action. It shows you that Swiles is a guy that throws well on the move, and I've already put a star by his name as someone within my area that I got to go check out and scout this season, because he's put together some good plays in this game, just throwing on the move. I want to see more of him in a live rapid-fire game where he's going to get constant reps, you know, series after series.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, there's so much good talent out here that we've seen in all three games, and Suazo, an exciting player, that's for sure.
And these guys are in this game for a reason. I mean, this is a tough decision for the Team USA staff to make.
So Suazo and Magapinto in the backfield together. Suazo fakes the handoff. Now the slant. This one's going to be picked off. Second interception there, and there may be a second pick six. It will be. Touchdown, Team Blue, as making the big play for Team Blue, Jayshon Hardy.
Hardy is a guy that also plays wide receiver. He showed it right there, catching the pass, wasn't scared by the football coming in an awkward position, and took it to the house.
So somehow, Team Blue with their third defensive touchdown of the game. That is amazing.
Defensive coaches across the country are jumping up and down, seeing the output by Team Blue at every level. D-line, linebackers, and secondary. Everyone has made a play. And three times they got the ball in the end zone.
So now, I would assume we're going to see Team Blue. They will go for two. And coming out to run the two-point play, Chauncey Caldwell. So we'll see what Caldwell does here. He comes out in a... comes out in a four-wide set with a tight end as well, and now we'll have a timeout. Maybe Team Blue didn't get what they were looking for. So we'll bring them over. Both teams will come over and talk with their coaches, and obviously important play here for both sides if you're Team Blue and if you're Team Silver.
Yeah, six-minute mark. You want to go ahead on and get the two-point conversion, make it a seven-point game, and this is the point of the game, of the part of the game where whether you have 23 or 24 doesn't, 22 or 23 doesn't affect you as much, but you want 24 because you want them to be able to score and kick the extra point to tie and not beat you.
Of course, so many people when it comes to USA football to thank. Of course, look at our board of directors and some who's who when it comes to the world of football on that list. And you get a look at some of the folks there, including Roger Goodell, the commissioner of the NFL, Joe Brown as well, Carl Peterson, longtime GM of the Kansas City Chiefs, some of the other names on there as well in that board of directors. Of course, Mark Murphy played locally, was part of the Washington Redskins, now runs the Green Bay Packers. So now back for the two-point conversion. Caldwell now has a back in the backfield with him. Caldwell's going to roll to his right, going to throw this one up, and this one's going to be incomplete, and he's going to be brought down. So that basically at this point, folks, again, kind of throws another wrinkle into this, that if the Silver team goes down, scores, gets the two-point conversion, opens up for a field goal on the other end. So we could see some exciting finishes here when it comes to our final game of the day.
I think when you say this missed extra point or two-point conversion attempt, that now Team Blue has to count on their defense, I think that's something that they actually in this situation might want to do, because their defense have put two touchdowns on the board.
So let's see where they go. The only offensive touchdown drive of the game for Team Silver. And again, we're going to have another pick six. And if fumble loses the ball out of bounds, we're going to have another defensive touchdown. But getting a little over-eager was Al-Malik Fitzpatrick, made the great play and then fell to the ground. We hope he's okay. His teammates kind of looked at him like he was, like he wasn't. We're hoping that's all it was. Maybe he did, as we'll look across the field. But looks like he's okay.
His pride hurt because he dropped the football. He could have went in for a touchdown. But that's a great play. That's great. Concentration on the ball being tipped in the air, keeping your eye on the football while also keeping aware of where the receiver is on the field, coming away with the football, getting your offense back on the field. And we just joked about Team Blue counting on their defense. They come back with a great play and puts them in position to put more points on the board.
Now, if you're Team Silver, obviously you got to go ahead and hold them to a field goal if you want a good shot at winning this thing. Touchdown, give it up, wouldn't kill you at this point. Still a lot of time left, but make it a lot easier if you can get the stop. Low snap. This time will not be a turnover as Caldwell doing a good job just to fall on the ball.
Yeah, just eat it. Let the play another down, and don't take any unwanted risk right here on this end of the field when you're staring a touchdown or at least three in the face.
Yeah, we talked about this before the game, knowing situational football, knowing that you got a chance to fight another day, even if you get a three-yard loss, you still got two more cracks at the end zone.
Exactly. Even a field goal here puts you up eight with less than 5 minutes left to play.
Caldwell going to take the snap, fakes the handoff. This one out. Chavis incomplete. Some pressure applied by one of the DBs. So that's going to bring up a third and goal, but third and goal from back at the 13-yard line. So they got to get it to the end zone.
And now right here, you saw the ball being placed out in front of Chavis. Chavis tells the quarterback he wants it in his chest. But it's tough in that situation because you have a hard-charging defensive back coming right at you, and you want to put the ball out in front, but you don't want to run the risk of putting it where Chavis wanted it because you don't know who it's in the eye of beholder, whether it's going to be a lateral or an incomplete pass. Put it out in front. That way, if it falls flat, it's an incomplete and not a fumble.
And now a timeout's going to be taken by Team Blue, and a very important time here for them to make sure they have the right play call with 5:11 left to go in the contest here in the fourth quarter, as Team Blue leads Team Silver 22-17. Remember, of all the scores we've had in this game, only one of them has come on offense. The rest of them have been defense or the two field goals we saw come off the foot of Kyle Corbett. And again, almost Team Blue, as you saw just moments ago, had a chance at their fourth defensive score of the game. I can't even think of any game I've ever seen. You know, maybe that Bears Cardinals game, the Dennis Green, we let him off the hook
right.
Game. That one had a bunch of defensive and special team scores in that, but this has been a wacky and wild one. If you want some quality defensive playmakers, this is a game for you.
I mean, these guys have been laying it out on the field throughout the course of the game. Both sides defensively have brung it each and every play, and I'm happy to see this level of intensity coming from the defensive side.
So Caldwell gonna roll to his right. Throws, lobs it into the end zone. Incomplete. Had a chance to go ahead and hook up with Scott Scherzer. May have gotten in there from the defensive back, Aiden Brown. Can't hook up, so at this point, they'll go ahead and send the field goal unit on.
And you talk about a great placement on the throw. That ball was perfectly placed to where the receiver had a chance to make it. It was a tough catch, but it was a good catch. That's a good throw right there by the QB. That actually should have been a touchdown.
So Corbett will put this one up, and it'll be good. So Corbett making it fun today. His one missed extra point, but then the kick there, it's going to make it an eight-point game. So if Team Silver can go down and score the two-point conversion, or can score the touchdown, we'll have some drama with a two-point conversion.
Now we got to worry about Team Blue, Team Defensive Blue, coming back out and having their say. But this would be a great opportunity for the offense to come out and go aggressive and go down the field and try to, you know, regain some of that confidence they had earlier in the game when they were moving the football at will.
Today's game brought to you in part by Flip Give, Gatorade, Sports Authority, Rydell, Volt Athletic, and Siege Sports. So we're going to see handoff up the middle as DeMarcus Ramsey will take it back into the game at the quarterback spot, Connor Fitzsimmons. Going to have a gain of about two on the play.
And understanding it's an eight-point game, they're looking at, okay, we have a ground game. We have been able to have success running the football. We can take our time. We don't have to get it all in one play. Let's work our way down the field.
Fitzsimmons sends three receivers to his right. A lot of pressure. He's going to lose it. Fitzsimmons jumps on top of the ball, but all the way back at the 10-yard line. Again, another good play by the defense. This time, I believe that was Gregory Smalls making the play off the corner.
Out of Lando Lakes, Florida, a little bit north of Tampa. And when you look at what he was able to do right there, he plays with good length. And you see him extend and not necessarily get the sack, but cause enough to disrupt right there. Strip the ball and force a big loss in a crucial situation for Team Silver.
And interestingly, Smalls, at least in our program, is listed as a defensive back, but showing some good pass rush skills there.
Coming off the edge with his hand in the dirt, you like to see that versatility.
Again, he's the one we talked about that plays 6-on-6 football, maybe comes from that background. Quick screen pass out, that's going to go for nothing. Brought down Travell Calvin as about 4 or 5 blue shirts get over there and swarm him under.
Yeah, tough to make 4 guys miss, let alone, you know, tough to make 1 guy miss, let alone 4. Great team defense once again by the Blue Squad.
So we'll see Corbett come on again. And obviously with the modified rules, a little different than if a rush was coming at him, but still an all-important kick. This one going to be a little bit low. It'll be taken just short of the 50-yard line by Chavis. And at this point, a nice drive by the blue team could go ahead and end this game. Obviously, Team Silver looking for one last defensive stand.
And we're going to learn a lot about Team Silver's defense and how much mental toughness they have in this situation. 2:46, you need the football back. You got to play aggressive, but you also have to play smart. So you don't want to get out of position where you give up a cheap big play. Now it's time to play great, smart, physical, and aggressive defense. And they're running this football because of the tight end and where he's aligned in man on line of scrimmage.
Hand off. Off left tackle, trying to break the tackle. Doesn't break it completely, but a good job to go ahead and get a little extra yardage by Amadou Dunbar.
And Justin Acosta held on for dear life out of Virginia Beach. And this is a guy, again, he was waiting for his teammates to come and help him. But he held that play to what it is, what, a 3 or 4 yard gain when it could have been a 15 yard gain had he missed that tackle. But now you want to see these guys get stops. It's 2nd and 7. Get a stop and make it 3rd and long or 3rd and medium. And that way you have a better chance of getting off the field and getting your offense the ball back.
So a gain of 3. They need to take it to the 39-yard line for a first down. Actually, just short of the 39 will get them the first down. Timeout taken by Team Silver as they're looking to conserve a little bit of time on the back end and have a chance to go ahead and answer and tie this one up. Again, Caldwell will stay at quarterback. And Dunbar will stay your running back. Tight end into the game after 4 wides most of the game. Dunbar, actually no, kept by Caldwell. He'll go down. Gets the 2-yard gain and make sure that Team Silver has to take that time out.
Now comes the biggest play of the game, and this could essentially be the ball game. If they're able to convert this 3rd down, it's going to be tough for Team Silver to come back.
Again, one last defensive stop. That's what Coach Adam Neugebauer looking for in this contest. Give his offense one last chance. And again, you got to remember, Team Silver was the one team that has scored an offensive touchdown in this game, so they've got confidence that they could do it again if they just get the ball back.
And what was interesting, when they scored that offensive touchdown and they stopped Team Blue, they came back out on offense, and I was like, hey, they can put this game away early. Then the defensive touchdown started to happen for Team Blue, and they now are in a position to win this one. I spoke too soon.
3rd and 5 here. Need to get it to the the other way down to the 39-yard line, for first down. Showing blitz by Team Silver. Caldwell takes around the end. He's got first down yardage. Caldwell with the keeper. Able to move the chains, and that's a big first down for Team Blue.
You want to say about 9 minutes in this game, Caldwell seemed to have gotten a glow from the old Last Dragon movie. He became a different player. He became more confident, and was able to move the chains and was able to make big plays for Team Blue offensively.
Dunbar and Caldwell in the backfield. Dunbar is going to get it off left tackle. He'll be brought down after a gain of four. It's going to set up second and seven. Again, just trying to run clock. Here in our final of our three USA football development games here at Towson University. Caldwell again in the shotgun. They'll split the tight end out, make him a receiver. Dunbar up the middle, finds a big silver wall, maybe gets a yard.
Most important thing for Dunbar right now is protect the football.
Team Silver going to take their last timeout of the game. They cannot stop the clock again. This contest brought to you in part by Siege Sports, Physio Control, St. Vincent Sports Performance, CVS Minute Clinic, Marriott, Field Turf, and Upper Deck. So right now, Emery, if you're in, let's put you in both huddles. What are you doing right now if you're Team Blue? What are you calling?
Team Blue, I'm calling a run play with Dunbar, telling him to protect the football. Or if I just want to be extra safe, I'm putting it in the hands of my quarterback, letting him run. He's amped up right now. And if I'm on the defensive side for Team Silver, sound football. It's third down. You don't have to be overly aggressive. Make a safe play. Be aggressive, but be smart. And that way you can possibly get these guys off the field. We don't need a lot of time. We just need some time to make something happen, and this is a big play.
Calling it third and seven. Caldwell shakes off one tackler, will get positive yardage. Actually gets a gain of about three, but it'll be well short of the first down.
And that was a great play. That's exactly what you want. Get these guys off the field. Don't be over-aggressive. You saw a lot of guys go for the strip. You want to see that. Being aggressive but being smart. They didn't sacrifice the tackle. Got them on the ground. Fourth down. They're going to run the clock until the last possible moment to probably take a timeout. And then either punt the ball or kick a field goal.
So now they'll run up. It looks like they're going to go for it. Maybe going to try and get them to jump off sides. They're going to go for it. Dunbar up the middle. This is going to be very, very close. Depends on the spot. And I think he's going to be short by half a yard.
I think he's going to be short, man, which is what that's probably the ideal situation for Team Silver. Get this football back. You have 49 seconds, you know, maybe 65-plus yards to go. It can happen.
It's funny. I thought for 1 second with the modified special teams rules, obviously no, you can't have it blocked because they're letting him kind of free kick it. If they would have just ran the clock down and let the way Caldwell's kicked, it's not out of the question that he could have hit that, especially with no rush. Right. Instead, they go ahead and they'll get 36 seconds here. So at this point, if you're Suazo, got to get some chunks, but it's a possibility.
It's a possibility, especially with the way this game has gone.
Suazo looking deep. Magapinto, this one's going to be incomplete. Shot at an interception coming over the top. Deontay Jones, that is, knocking that one away. Two guys had a shot of it. Neither one of them came down with it.
And Jamel Wiggins, number 25, was also in the mix on that play. And we've seen him make great plays on the ball, facing up and finding the football and really stopping the play where it wanted to go. You're going to see right here, slowing down. He could have easily, a lot of DBs tend to want to follow the receiver and keep their back to the football. Did a great job turning around and finally and making the play.
Second and 10. Four wide receivers. Magapinto the lone back. Suazo down the middle of the field. Trying for Kervin. Instead, will be picked off by Deontay Jones. He'll go down, and that'll seal the victory for Team Blue.
That's a great job. Great headsy play. Heads-up play right there by Deontay Jones. Getting down and not risking a fumble or anything crazy happening. But another interception. This is, what, the fourth or fifth interception by Team Blue. Great defensive effort by this football team.
And we see it right there. Jones had the pick six early in the game. This time he gets the game-clinching interception as Team Blue going to go ahead and win this one. Looks like they're just going to go ahead and run the time off, and that's going to do it as the Team Silver goes ahead and gets the victory today by a score of 25-17 in a defensive battle.
Yeah, this was a great game. Fun game to watch from a defensive perspective. Even the offenses were fun to watch because they made it interesting in how they were able to move the football. But you had to come away very impressed with how defensively both teams played.
And here's a look at that last play by Jones.
Great play, high point, get down, get on the bus, get home, and get some rest. These guys have been playing a lot of football.
They have, and it's been a wonderful week here out at Towson. And obviously, these guys can be happy with their performance and all the things they were able to do this week. Well, that's going to do it for us from here at Towson University. Look at our production crew. A great job by all of them today. Also, want to thank our sideline reporter, Jack Feely, and my partner today, Emery Hunt. I'm Jeremy Huber. That's going to do it for our broadcast here for the USA Football Development Games in Baltimore. Our final score of the day, Team Blue beats Team Silver 25-17. Good afternoon, everybody.